हरि ओम ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिगं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पता आनश्चुन्मन्नोतिभिः सीदसाधनं ओम महागणाधिपतये नमः। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। नमस्ते। Welcome to the seventh session of Introduction to Upanishad, in which we are going to study Taittiriya Upanishad in today's class. Today's speakers are all set to give you a glimpse of the beauty of Taittiriya Upanishad to you. Dr. Anupama will first give us a short summary of Keno Upanishad, which we studied last week. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Keno Upanishad, a recap. This Upanishad belongs to Samaveda, unique for the use of paradoxical language. The Shantipata goes like this: Apyayantu Mamagani, Vak, Prana, Chakshuhu, Shrotram, and so on. Here, seeks fitness of his body and mind for the acquisition of Brahma Jnana. He invokes the grace of God for the transformation of his Paroksha Jnana into Aparoksha Jnana. The Upanishad starts with a mind-boggling question which is asked by the student. What is that factor or deva or illuminator within me which makes this inert body-mind complex sentient? It is evident that the answer to this question is Brahman. It is here that we see the use of paradoxical knowledge to explain the inexplicable. Here, we are shown the gap between neurosciences and Brahma Vidya. Take this example. Something, the visual inputs in the form of images are formed on the retina of the eye and are then reported to the brain. Now, to whom does the brain report this information? The guru answers, Shrotrasya Shrotra Manaso Manoyad Vachoha Vacham Sa Upranasya Pranaha Chakshushah Chakshuhu Atimuchya Dhiraha Pretya Asmat Lokat Amrutam Bhavanti. This is Atma Anatma Viveka. The Guru explains the subtle difference between the subject Atma and the object, the Anatma, the body-mind complex. He says it is the ear of the ear, implying that it's something other than the ear, that which expresses the hearing of the ear. Similarly, the mind of the mind, tongue of etc. Brain reports this information to Deva Deva or Jyotishyam Jyoti. It is a light of consciousness that illumines the sense of Bhati Sarvam. Now, is the Atma known or unknown? The Guru says, the eye does not go there. Na tatra chakshuhu gachyati, no speech, no mind, na vaak gachyati na manaha. We do not therefore know it, na vignyo, nor do we know any process of instruction about it. Meaning, the Atma is neither known nor is it unknown. This is paradoxical language again. What are the categories of knowledge? Knowledge could be known or, second, unknown. Unknown is a surrounding ocean of ignorance, which with time and technology perhaps could be known. The third is unknowable. This is neither known nor unknown. The self, the knower, the subject is therefore unknowable, as it can never become the object of knowledge. The Guru says that it is only the dhiraha, the qualified student, who can transcend this body-mind complex, adi muchyati, and realize the Atma and attain immortality, amrataha bhavanti. As Brahman is sarva pramana agocharam, no specific effort is needed to experience Brahman because it is the very adhishtanam or substratum of every experience. Prati bodha vihitam matam. We use our extroverted sense organs to search outside of ourselves and look for one more thing which we can call the Atma or consciousness. Remember the story of the 10th man? Using our minds, we could reach the deepest thought, memory, or even an understanding. Beyond that, if I look for consciousness, I will never find it because it will be looking for the one who is searching, the subject who can neither be objectified, grasped, nor described. How can this knower know itself? The Upanishad says, that which is aware of this I is the real I. Self-realization is therefore shifting of our attention from the object of experience to the subject, the Atma. Kshetrajnam chapi mam vidhi sarva kshetre subharata. As Lord Krishna says, the knower principle in you is none other than me. This Mahavakya is the ultimate knowledge of Brahma Vidya. With this awareness, our Upanishadic journey is just over. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Anupama, for a good recap of that great Upanishad, the Keno Upanishad. Om Akhanda Mandala Karam Vyaptam Yena Characharam Tatpadam Darshitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. We study the Taittiriya Upanishad, which is part of the Krishna Yajurveda. It is part of the Taittiriya Aranyaka, which has 10 chapters. The last four chapters constitute the Upanishads, of which 7, 8, and 9 have been commented by Adi Shankara, and 7 becomes the Shiksha Valli of the Taittiriya Upanishad. 8 is the Brahma Valli. These two we will be covering in today's class. The 9th is Bhrigu Valli. The 10th, because it has not been commented by Adi Shankara, now becomes a minor Upanishad called the Mahanarayana Upanishad. All these have very beautiful mantras, which we often hear in any temple when the priests are chanting these mantras. Adi Shankara has given a very brilliant commentary. His commentary is supposed to be he's supposed to be at his best in his commentary in the Taittiriya. It has also been commented by Vidyaranya Swami, which is called the Anubhuti Prakasha. And Adi Shankara says, in this Upanishad, freedom is hidden. We need to be able to discover it. And study of this Upanishad gives total fulfillment. Our attempt here is to, just like when we go to certain places where they give you a taste of wine, it is just tasting it. And one day when we study it, this is a nice form of an intoxication. And the Taittiriya Upanishad, especially the Brahmananda Valli, can be really intoxicating as far as the heights of ananda to which a person can delight. In today's class, we will be seeing a unique Shanti Patha. The uniqueness in Taittiriya Upanishad is each of these Vallis. Valli means creeper. Creeper means because the mantras are like the flowers on the creepers. Each of these sections are called Vallis. There are three Vallis. The first one, Shiksha Valli, has got a unique Shanti Patha called Om Shanno Mitra Sham Varunaha. When chanted, it is very delightful to hear, and you will hear Venkatesh Prasad chant it and explain this. Then there is a beautiful mantra on Omkara. Yes, Chandasa Rishamo Vishwarupaha. Rishabha. Rishabha means Sreshta. It is all about Omkara and how Omkara sadhana can give us so much benefits. We will hear the familiar terms Matra Devo Bhava, Pitra Devo Bhava, Satyam Vada, Dharmam Chara. When students have gone through the course and when they are graduating, what is the message? That is all part of the first Valli or the Shiksha Valli, which has a lot of delightful mantras. The real Upanishadic teaching comes in the Brahmananda Valli, which begins with a very cryptic verse, which will be explained by Dr. Anupama, beginning with Brahmavid Apnoti Param, and which is elaborated as Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma or Satchit Ananda, Brahman as Satchit Ananda. We will begin with the Shanti Pata. Venkatesh Prasad, please.
Thank you, sir. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. This is a beautiful Shanti mantra from Shikshavalli of Taittiriya Upanishad. Let me chant the mantra. Om Shanno Mitra Sham Varunaha Shanno Bhavat Varyama Shanna Indro Bruhaspatihi Shanno Vishnururukramaha Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami Rutam Vadishyami Satyam Vadishyami Tanmam Avatu Tadvattaram Avatu Avatu Mam Avatu Vattaram Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Here the student is praying for two things. Next slide, sir. Jnana Yogyata Prapti, number one. Eligibility to receive knowledge. To receive knowledge, all sense organs must be in fit condition. 17 organs comprise of 5 sense organs, 5 organs of action, 5 physiological system, the mind and intellect. Some of these organs should cooperate by doing something and certain other organs by not doing anything. For example, at the time of Shravanam, sense organs should be active and not the organs of action. Each organ is presided over by a deity, Adhishtana Devata. Pratibandha Nivritti is the second benefit. The second prayer is for removal of any obstacle in the application of any my organs. Let there not be any obstacle related to myself, Adhyatmika, on which I have control, environmental, Adi Bhautika, on which I have limited control, and natural disasters, Adi Daivika, on which I have absolutely no control. As we move to the next slide, 7 presiding devatas are invoked here. Mitra. Mitra Devata presides the exhalation breath, Prana. Varuna. Varuna Devata presides over the inhalation breath, Apana. O Lord, when I am doing Shravanam, let my breathing continue unobstructed. Aryama. Aryama is the Surya Devata who presides over Chakshu, eyes. May my eyes be in good condition. Indra. Indra presides over arms and hands. I pray for my strength. Brihaspati. Brihaspati represents intelligence and communication. Pray for ability to understand and communicate with appropriate manner. Vishnu Rurukramaha. Vishnu Urukrama is the Lord of the feet. Padayor Vishnu. He gives capacity to move, do Guru Seva. Even to sit at one place for an hour, legs must cooperate. Vayu. Vayu Brahma is Hiranyagarbha, who is subtle body. Being subtle, he is not visible. He is available as Vayu, Samashti Prana, the air we breathe. Vayu, the Samashti Prana, represents Hiranyagarbha, Samashti Sukshma Sharira. Next slide, sir. Shambhavatu. Let all these devatas be a source of auspiciousness, strength. This statement is added before all the devatas. Na. For us, this prayer for both student and teacher. Teacher's organs should also function properly. His memory should be clear and strong so that he remember and communicate his guru's teachings. Namo Brahmane Namaste Vayo. I offer prostration to Vayu Brahma, who is Hiranyagarbha. Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi. Hiranyagarbha, who is imperceptible, Paroksha Devata, as mind, becomes perceptible in the form of Vayu, Pratyaksha Devata, and can be experienced by the nostrils. Each time I breathe, I am in contact with God. Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahma Vadishyami. I declare that you are available as Vayu, the Pratyaksha Brahma. I want to spread the word, Tvameva Pratyaksham Brahmasi Iti Vadishyami. Ritam Vadishyami, Satyam Vadishyami. I declare that you are Ritam and Satyam. Ritam means living your life according to what I have learned. Satyam is proper knowledge acquired from scriptures, Shastras. Hence, Satyam is right knowledge, Ritam is right action. Up to this point, prayer is for yogyata prapti. Now, it is for pratibandha nivritti. Tanmam avatu. May Hiranyagarbha protect me from obstacles. Tad vaktaram avatu. May Lord keep my guru vaktaram also healthy. Student offers this prayer once again for emphasis. Avatu mam, protect me. Avatu vaktaram, protect my guru. As we move on to next slide. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. O Lord, remove threefold obstacles, trivida pratibandhas, adhyatmika, adibhautika, and adidaivika. Hari Om. Thank you.
Thank you, Venkatesh Prasad, for a nice explanation of the Shanti Pata of the Shikshavalli of the Taittiriya Upanishad. Om Shanno Shanno Mitra Sham Varunaha. Dr. Ravi Shankar will explain this beautiful mantra, which is the extract from all the Vedas, which is the best Vrishabha among all the mantras about Omkara. Dr. Ravi Shankar, please.
Shri Guru Bhyo Namaha. This mantra is from the Taittiriya Upanishad as well as the Shanti Mantra of the Medha Sutta. Let me recite it. Om Yas Chandasam Rishabho Vishwarupaha Chandodhyot Amrita At Sambhuva Samindro Medhaya Aspranotu Amritasya Deva Dharano Bhuyasam Shariram Me Vicharshanam Jifva Me Madhumattama Karna Abhyam Bhuri Vishruvam Brahmana Koshosi Medhaya Pihitaha Shrutam Me Gopaya Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Next slide, sir. The Omkara which manifests from eternal Vedas is the greatest of the Veda mantras endowed with manifold form. May Lord, the Omkara, strengthen my intelligence. May I become the enjoyer of immortal wisdom. May my body be healthy. May my tongue be very sweet. May I listen to the scriptures again and again. You are the abode of Brahman, which is verily wielded by the worldly intelligence. May you protect me. Whatever is heard by me is the gist of this mantra. Let us dwell deeper into it as we see in the next slide. Yeah. Chandasam. Yah is that Omkara, the Pranava mantra, where Brahmaji extracted this Omkara from the Vedas by intellectual journey as a Veda Sara. From the Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, and the Sam Veda came the essence, like in the form of a Gayatri mantra. And that was further condensed as Bhuhu Bhuvaha Suha, and then the A U Ma essentially being Om. Omkara Rupa Ishwara is invoked to get Jnana Yogyata Prapti in this prayer. Chandasam refers to the Vedas. Rishabha, Nandi is the best devotee of Lord Shiva, and Nandi is the bull which has the strength and it stands out. Omkara is referred to as the bull, as the most important, the strength of the Vedic hymns, the object of profound meditation and a symbol or the pratika of Brahman, which is the quintessence of Vedas. It appears as manifold in the form of the universe and hence the word Vishwarupa. Like a midriff of a leaf which holds the Vedas and the universe all together. Chandobhyo is from the Vedas. And Adi Amrita is the timeless Amrita which has emerged, Sambhuva. Indra stands out amongst the Devas like a bull. Let that Omkara bless me, Sprunotu, with intelligence and wisdom, Medhaya. Bless me here means strengthening, and Swami Paramarthanandaji explains it The strengthening should be physical, as the diksha, in the form of verbal, for better communication, to ask questions and to comprehend. Hearing, which is the basic shravanam, and also should be intellectual, to have a sharp, subtle, and a good cognitive power. In the next slide, we see the Lord, Om, as Deva, may I become Bhuyasam, the possessor or dharanam of this elixir of self-knowledge, which is Amritasya, which is nothing but Atmajnana. Let this body and the senses be strong, Shariram me vicharshanam. Let the tongue be very sweet. It should be very sweet, which is Madhu, Mat, and Tama. And Swami Paramarthanandji very nicely says, it is Vak Shakti and Vak Indriya, which should be noble and auspicious. Let me speak the truth, which is Satyam, and it should never hurt anybody. It should be Priyam and Hitam. In the next slide, we will see Karnabhyam, from my ears, with my ears, may I hear Vishruvam, Bhuri, abundantly, and again and again. And what should I hear? The Shastras. Brahmana here refers to the Brahman. Kosha is covered. Like a sword is covered by the scabbard. O Lord, O Omkara, you are the one that covers the Brahman. You are the jewel box. Knowing Om is like knowing Brahman. Pihita, the Om itself is now covered by Medhaya. In this context, our teacher explains that Medhaya means worldly intelligence, and this worldly intelligence is Anatma, and this Anatma obstructs Vedanta Vichara. Omkara turns Medha Shakti inwards. A seeker of Brahma Vidya needs one-pointedness and a higher level of intelligence, which is Viveka and discrimination. What is heard by me, Shrutam of the Shastras? Gopaya, let it protect me. And how does it protect? By retaining the knowledge, by understanding the knowledge, and not being forgetfulness. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Hari Om, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ravi Shankar, for a very nice explanation of this mantra. Om Yes Chandasam Rishabho Vishwarupaha. A very, very popular mantra from the Taittiriya Upanishad. You will hear it chanted on so many occasions, and your explanation should help us to remember the significance of this mantra and also motivate us to learn how to memorize and chant this mantra. Thank you very much. We have another very beautiful mantra, which is part of the instructions to students on the importance of how they should study and how they must teach, including the various sadhanas that you do need to do, the karma yoga, the upasana yoga sadhanas. We have heard of pancha maha yajna. All that will come from here. Dr. Divakar, please.
Thank you very much, sir. Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. I will attempt chanting this beautiful rhythmic verse. Ritancha swadhyaya pravachanecha, satyancha swadhyaya pravachanecha, tapascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, dhamascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, shamascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, agnayascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, agnihotrancha swadhyaya pravachanecha, atithayascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, manushancha swadhyaya pravachanecha, prajacha swadhyaya pravachanecha, prajanascha swadhyaya pravachanecha, prajatischa swadhyaya pravachanecha, satyamiti satyavacharathi tharah, tapaiti tapo nityah paurushishtihi, swadhyaya pravachane evetinako maudgalyah, taddita pastaddita paha. Next slide, sir. Vedanta or Upanishads mainly deal with Jnana Yoga, which is the only sadhana to attain moksha. Some sections of Upanishads has Veda Purva, which is Dharma Shastra, dealing with karma and Upasana Yoga, and this is the prerequisite to enter into Jnana Yoga. One such section is Shikshavali of Taittiriya Upanishad, which emphasizes karma and Upasana Yoga. Next two sections, Brahmanandavalli and Bhrguvalli, deals with Jnana Yoga. In this section, up to Anuvaka 8, various Upasanas are elaborated. In the 9th Anuvaka, importance of Karma Yoga, particularly for Gruhasthas, is highlighted. It is interesting to note that Karma Yoga is mentioned after Upasana Yoga. But if we look at it carefully, Karma Yoga and Upasana Yoga are two sides of the same coin, as in order to have the attitude of Ishwara Arpana and Ishwara Prasada Bhava of Karma Yoga, one has to have mental purity, which comes from Upasana Yoga. And on the other hand, various forms of meditations in Upasana Yoga are also karmas, which has to be done with the right attitude. Without Upasana Yoga, karma will only be roga, as it leads to samsara. In the next slide, we will see the Karma Yoga is taught using two headings in this verse: Daivi Sampat, which is the spiritually conducive virtues or divine values, and Pancha Mahayagnas, which are the obligatory daily duties, also called as Sattvika Karmas. Last section of the Anuvaka talks about great acharyas who endorse some of these sadhanas. In the next slide, we will see the meaning. Swadhyaya Pravachanecha. This is repeated several times in this verse. Therefore, this Anuvaka is also called as Swadhyaya Prashamsa. It means, do regular scriptural study and teach what you have learned. This is such a wonderful guidance from the Upanishad, which is applicable for any field of knowledge, not just spiritual. More we teach and more we share, more refined we become in that subject. While the listeners get benefited, the biggest beneficiary is the teacher. Param Vedanta team too is inspired by this Upanishadic guidance and is employing this teach to learn model. So Upanishad is categorically stating that we should study and teach Swadhyaya and Pravachana while abiding to other prescribed karmas or virtues. In the next slide, we will see the five divine virtues, Daivi Sampat, which are highlighted here. Ritam, as Venkatesh Prasad has already said, Ritam is keeping our life in rhythm with Shastras. Satyam, leading a truthful life, closing the gap between what I know and what I do, that is walking the talk. In the second chapter, which you will see later, Brahmanandavalli, Satyam refers to Brahman. Tapaha, which is austerity, willful self-denial to gain mastery over our Jnanendriyas and Karmendriyas and also our Manas. Examples are Upavasam and Maunam. Tapaha is not suppression of our urges, because suppression leads to secret indulgences. How do we test how much tapas we have? By doing voluntarily, by voluntarily saying no to whatever which gives us the instant happiness and observing our own mind and behavior. For example, mobile phones, pizzas, Netflix, cricket, etc. If we have any withdrawal symptoms after stopping this, it simply confirms that our sense objects has taken control over us and we should practice tapaha in order to gain our control back. Damaha is the mastery over our sense control. Again, this is not suppression. Shamaha is the mind discipline, and to be more specific, it is thought discipline. Tapaha is not possible without the mastery over sense organs and the mind. In the next slide, we will see the Pancha Mahayagnas, which are discussed in this verse. Agnayaha and Agnihotram refers to Vedic rituals, which grihastas are expected to perform. This represents Deva Yajna. In the current times, doing daily prayers, puja, etc. can be considered as Deva Yajna, offering to the God. Atithayaha, respecting and taking care of guests. This is embedded in our culture and it comes from this Upanishad. Atithi is the one who visits us without any prior notice. Manushancha, duty towards the fellow human beings, especially those who are in need. Manava Seva is Madhava Seva. Atithayaha and Manusha Seva represents Manushya Yajna. Then comes Pitriyagna, represented by Prajacha, begetting children, Prajanascha, duty towards family and parents, Prajatischa, duties in continuing the generations, duty for perpetuating our Vedic parampara. And this is part of Pitriyagna. Here, Upanishad talks about converting even our instinctive and natural processes such as procreation into a sacred Vedic ritual. Brahma Yajna is represented by Swadhyaya Pravachana, scriptural studying under a competent guru and propagating it by teaching. We have to add Bhuta Yajna, duties towards animals and environment, into this Panchamahayajna. In the next slide, we will see the last segment, that great rishis have endorsed some of the values which they consider as the most important. Rati Taraha, also called Satyavachaha, says Satyam is the highest virtue. Paurushishtihi, also called Tapo Nitya, who is the embodiment of Tapaha, says Tapas is the greatest sadhana. Maudgalyaha, also called Nakaha, endorses Swadhyaya Pravachana is the best sadhana. Here, this Upanishad too endorses Maudgalyaha and says Swadhyaya Pravachana, which is the Brahma Yajna, is the highest sadhana as it propels the sadhaka towards liberation. Hari Om, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Divakar, for a very clear explanation of the verse allotted to you, in which you brought out the various upasanas like karma and upasana, the Panchamahayajna, the emphasis being Swadhyaya Pravachanecha. You should always learn and teach. And the best way to learn is to see yourself as a potential teacher, which we call as a three-person listening. And when you see that you have to teach this to somebody else, your learning is going to be much more intense. We come to another part of the Upanishad, the concluding part of the Shiksha Valley, which Rama Gopalakrishna will explain to us, where we hear these very familiar terms like Matra Devo Bhava, Pitra Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava. Ramaji, please.
Hari Om, Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. After the completion of their studies, Shishyas are returning home to embrace the householder's life, which is the proper place for the discharge of worldly duties. One should perform these karmas as an offering to attain Chitta Shuddhi and not to neglect them at the expense of their spiritual growth. This set of instructions are also known as Samavartanam, the instructions that will help the Shishyas to readjust to family and social life are given in this mantra. The first part, Deva Pitru Karyabhyam Na Pramaditavyam. Do not neglect your duties to gods and ancestors. Performing Deva Karya or Deva Yajna gives two benefits. The universal prayer will help the world and one gets their mind purified. Contribute to the universal tree whose root is Ishvara, says Sri Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 15. Pitru Karyam is the worship of the ancestors in the form of Shraddha or Tarpana. It will reach them in an appropriate way. It is also extremely important. Thus, the ethics, values, and Panchamahayajnas have been addressed so far. In the following portion, the Upanishad discusses the attitude towards parents, gurus, and guests. The next part, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. Shankara Bhasha explains Mata, Pita, Acharya, and Atithi, that is the guests, are to be Devatavat Upasyaha, meaning may you offer pranams to Ishvara invoked in them with due reverence and proper services. Matru Devo Bhava. Mata Devaha Yasyasaha, to whom the mother is a deity, as such, Tvambhava, you do become. Similarly, you become Pitru Devaha, Acharya Devaha, and Atithi Devaha Bhava. Atithi was treated with reverence and considered as a messenger of God. The child has the first relationship with mother, later with the father, and many gurus who models its life. These three entities are the gateways of knowledge and understanding the world. They are the three axes for whatever we are today. Especially in the case of mother, Even a sannyasi has to worship his mother. Puja Swami Paramarthanandaji says that if relationships with Mata, Pita and Guru are healthy, the child will grow up to be a mature adult with a stable mind. Once the Shishas has learned the Shastras, he should rely less on the Guru and more on the Shastras, which lead him to the ultimate knowledge. The Guru talks of acquisition of Daivi Sampat and elimination of Asuri Sampat, described as Samskara by Sri Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. The next part of the mantra, Yani Anavadhyani Karmani, the ones that is open to blame or which do not deviate from the path recommended by the Shastras. They are our dharmic actions. Tani Sevitavyani, you should follow those alone. No itarani and not any other. That is avoiding blemish and adharmic actions. Yani asmakam sucharitani, the flawless actions performed by the Shreshtas as seen in Shishya's life. Tani twaya upasyani, you should diligently follow only those divine actions. No itarani. He further says that if Guru's actions are defective or with dharmic shortcomings, although he is the Guru, his Shishya should follow the Shastras and not the Guru's actions. Virtues cannot be learned from textbooks, but possible through the living example of a Sadguru. As Dr. Hegde mentions, that a skill cannot be taught, but can only be gained by observation and intuition. For virtues, Guru, an exemplary man, is the role model. These doctrines should be adhered to at all times by all beings and at all places for spiritual growth. Thank you, sir. Harivom, Sri Gurubhyo Namah.
Thank you, Ramaji, for another very clear explanation of this particular verse, which gives the importance of mother, father, guru, and atithi. How they need to be revered. All these verses are in prose form. That's why they are particularly long, but they have swaras. And so when chanted, you will see how delightfully musical they are to listen to them. With that, we have come to the end of the Shikshavalli, which has given us the necessary preparation to get Brahma Vidya. And Brahma Vidya is given in a cryptic form, in the form of a sutra mantra, which Dr. Anupama will explain. Dr. Anupama, please.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Taitriya Brahmanandavalli Anuvaka 1. Om Brahmavit Apnoti Param. The knower of Brahma attains the supreme. This is a sutra vakyam, that is, a single phrase that reveals the entire teaching. Brahma means big. The root of the word is bruhat, the superlative, just big. Vit means to know, not as pratyaksha or paroksha, but as aparoksha. Apnoti means to attain or realize. Param means purnatvam, fulfillment or liberation. This shloka, Brahmavit Apnoti Param, is explained as a vritti vakyam or a brief commentary in this verse. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma, yoveda nihitam guhayam parame vyoman, soshnute sarvan kaman saha brahmana vipaschita iti. Here, three questions are answered. First, kim tat brahman, what is brahman? Second, katam tasya vedanam, how can one know Brahman? And third, ka paraprapti, what is the meaning of moksha or purnatvam? This is a quotation from Rig Veda, which answers these questions, starting with kim tat brahman. The answer, satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Let's first learn the meanings of these four words. Brahman, as we have already seen, means infinite or big. Anantam means anantaha, without an end, limitless. Limitation or paricheda has three dimensions. First, spatial, desha. Second, temporal or kala. And third, attribute or object-wise limitation called vastu parichedanam. Brahman is therefore desha kala vastu paricheda rahitam or advaitam. Anantam therefore means advaitam. Satyam. Satyam means an existent object. Every existent object has three components, nama, rupa, and satta, meaning name, form, and existence. We have already said that Brahman is ananta. Therefore, by eliminating the limiting factors, nama and rupa, and retaining the satta, the ananta component, we can infer that satyam means pure, independent existence, as described in this verse, Yasyaiva spuranam sadatmakam asat kalpatakam bhasate. Next, jnanam. Jnanam means knowledge of an object which could be stored as a thought. This knowledge also has desha kala and vastu parichedana. Here again, by dropping the limiting nama and rupa and retaining the awareness of chit, which is anantam. Now, why is chit anantam? We know that vritti, bhava, abhava, sakshi, chaitanyam prevails at all times. Therefore, Brahman is satyam, jnanam, anantam, the limitless existence consciousness principle. The second question, katam tasya vedanam? The answer, yo veda nihitam guhayam parame vyoman. This is very similar to hiranmaye pare koshe. This is not the physical location of Brahman. It seems to imply that Brahman is located in the vijnanamaya kosha, the guha, which is in the sacred inner space of one's heart, the parame vyoman. But it just means that Brahman is recognizable or upalabhyate, not located here. Just as a temple is a place for the recognition and not location of the Lord. Now, how do we know that Brahman? We have to proceed like this. First, negate all the objects that can be experienced. Negate everything with attributes. Drop ahankara, drop mamakara, and what remains is pure awareness, the sakshi, I. The third question, ka para prapti. What do you mean by attaining the supreme? The answer, soshnute sarvan kaman saha brahmana vipaschitati. Saha means a brahma jnani. Ashnute means attains. Now, what does he attain? Brahmananda rupena sarva vishayananda prapnoti. That means, through Brahma Jnana, all finite Vishayanandas, that is the worldly desires, simultaneously resolve into this infinite Brahmananda. As Lord Krishna says, Prajahati yata kaman sarvan partha manogatan atmani eva atmana tushta sita prajna saha uchyate. This tripti includes saha tripta bhavati, saha sampurna bhavati, and saha santushta bhavati. This Purnatvam is called Paraprapti. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Anupama, for explaining the opening verse, which is a sutra verse. A sutra verse means something which has packed in the essence. It begins with a bang by saying, Brahma vid apnoti param. Literally, it means the one who knows Brahman becomes Brahman, if I can translate. Becomes Brahman means becoming infinite. The finite can never become the infinite. It means that you have always been that, but now you realize that there is nothing to be done. You are already that which you can be. Brahma vid apnoti param. And because it is too cryptic, the Upanishad now goes to Rig Veda. It goes to the Rig Veda to get an elaboration. What is this Brahma vid apnoti param? And then it defines Brahma vid, the knower of Brahman, or Brahman is Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam. The key word here, as explained, is Anantam or limitless. Brahman is limitless existence, limitless consciousness. And if you're able to understand what this limitless existence consciousness is, then it is said that you experience Purnatva. You experience fulfillment in this moment. There is nothing more that is required to be done in this life. Of course, the rest of the Upanishad goes on elaborating on these sutra verses, and that is the second valli. Then there is the third valli called the Bhrigu valli. The Bhrigu valli is a discussion between the father Varuna and the son Bhrigu, and there is a very nice discussion primarily through a prakriya called the Panchakosha Viveka, to be able to discover from Annamaya Kosha to Pranamaya Kosha to Manomaya Kosha to Vijnanamaya Kosha, beyond Anandamaya Kosha, to discover in a very sequential, stepwise manner the same messages taught once again. With that, we complete the glimpse of Taittiriya Upanishad. We go to another very, very delightful Upanishad. Although it is called a minor Upanishad, it is not minor in content. It is as rich, or, you know, really as rich as any other Upanishad. The uniqueness of Kaivalya is that it deals with meditation. There are six verses which deal with meditation, and therefore this becomes the seed for the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. A small Upanishad with two chapters together has about 25 mantras coming from the Atharva Veda. The word Kaivalya means Purnatvam, Kevala, Moksha, or total fulfillment. Kevala means there is no second. Advitiyam, there is nothing other. We have the introduction. The opening verses become Ashwalayana Rishi is a prepared student, and he comes to the Lord, the creator, Brahmaji, not Brahman, to know about Brahman. And he straightaway says, I want to know about Brahma Vidya. Can you tell me about Brahma Vidya? The opening verse of the teacher is Shraddha Bhakti Jnana, which commentators have said is Shravanam, Mananam, and Nidityasanam. And then there are certain beautiful verses which we generally chant whenever we receive a guru, a sannyasi. There are seed verses for the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, which explains all about meditation. The uniqueness of the Kaivalya Upanishad is preparing a mental frame of mind. That means when you are in the presence of your guru, how will your mind be? Nirudhya bhaktya swagurum pranamya. Like when I'm making my respects to my guru, what is the status of your mind? Can you have that mind in which you are able to do your meditation? And meditation gradually moves from ekarupa to vishwarupa or anekarupa to arupa. And subtly the student is brought to realize that the consciousness within me is the essential nature of the Lord. And in this Upanishad, more than any other Upanishad, you have a string of Mahavakyas concluding with Mayeva Sakalam Jatam, My Sarvam Pratishtitam. Every Upanishad brings in Omkara. And there is a very nice example in which how through the Arani example, how through how a spark is generated, and how about Omkara, symbolizing how you use your mind and through churning of the Upanishadic wisdom through Omkara. And that is all about Kaivalya Upanishad, which we will listen to in the next week. As part of preparation for Mahashivaratri, we will listen to this few verses of Lingashtakam. I will ask Meenakshi to chant each verse, and then I will explain the meaning of the key words. Meenakshi, please.
Hari Om. Brahma Murari Surarchita Lingam Nirmala Bhasita Shobhita Lingam Janmaja Dukha Vinashaka Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
Each verse concludes with Tat Pranami Sadashiva Lingam. Sadashiva is none other than Dakshinamurti. As I see the Linga, I visualize Dakshinamurti in the Linga itself, who is Sadashiva, always auspicious, who is adored by Brahma, Vishnu, and all the gods, who's Nirmala, who's pure, who is shining, self-shining, who is well adorned, and who will destroy all the sorrows associated with the human life. Next verse, please.
Deva Muni Pravararchita Lingam Kamadahana Karunakara Lingam Ravana Dalpa Vinashana Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
Deva Muni, one who is worshipped by the gods and the sages, one who burns all our desires, one who is compassionate, and one who destroys the pride of Ravana.
Sarva sugandha sulepita lingam buddhi vivardhana karana lingam siddha surasura vandita lingam tat pranamami sadashiva lingam.
Sarva sugandha, that one that, which is fragrant, and one which elevates your mental state, it elevates your intelligence, it brings in viveka in your mind, who's praised by all the siddhas, all the devas, and also all the asuras. That is the greatness of this sadashiva lingam. Continue.
Tanaka Mahamani Bhushita Lingam Panipati Veshtita Shobhita Lingam Daksha Suyajna Vinashaka Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
Kanaka means gold, Mahamani means various precious gems, or decorate the lingam. And of course, Shiva likes snakes, so it is always wrapped around by snakes. And it is the linga that destroyed the sacrifice of Daksha, the father of Shakti. Please continue.
Kumkuma chandana lepita lingam pankajahara sushobhita lingam Sanchita Papa Vinashana Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
This Sadashiva Lingam, which I adore, is adorned by kumkuma and chandana, sandal paste, with various lotus leaves. And this Linga has the ability to destroy all our accumulated karmas, which is called the Sanchita Karma.
Deva Ganarchita Sevita Lingam Bhavair Bhakti Bhireva Chalingam Dinakara Koti Prabhakara Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
Worshipped by all the devas, all the ganas, and who elevates your mood into a level of bhakti, into devotion. Dinakara means the sun, koti. It has the splendor of crores of suns.
Ashtadalopariveshtita lingam sarva samudbhava karana lingam Ashtadaritra vinashana lingam tat pranamami sadashiva lingam.
I offer my salutation to that Sadashiva Lingam, which is surrounded by the 8-petaled flowers, which is the cause of all creation and which destroys the 8 Daridra. The opposite of Daridra is the Aishwarya. What are the 8 Aishwaryas? Like health, wealth, peace, prosperity, grandchildren, success, long life, and fame. And absence of this are considered the Ashta Daridra. And Shivalinga, Sadashivalinga, will bless us or avoid these Ashtadaridra. And the final verse, Meenakshi, please.
Sura Guru Suravara Pujita Lingam Suravana Pushpa Sadarchita Lingam Paramapadam Paramatmaka Lingam Tat Pranamami Sadashiva Lingam.
The word Sura comes many times. Sura refers to the heavens. The Brihaspati is the teacher of all the lords, who is the best of all the gods, and whose the flowers obtained from a celestial garden is offered to this Shivalinga, and is Sreshta. It is the best and the greatest. And this is the poetic description of the Sadashivalinga, which I offer my prostration to. Thank you, Meenakshi. With that, we conclude today's class. Over to Venkatesh Prasad.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, friends. We have completed 7 sessions of this introduction to Upanishads and completed 4 Upanishads. We are going to study 3 more Upanishads in the coming 3 classes. Next Friday, as mentioned by Hegde sir, we will be taking up Kaivalya Upanishad for our study. As usual, on Monday, our Viveka Chudamani class will continue. Let's meet on Monday, same time for Viveka Chudamani. Please log in by 6:45 p.m. local time. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om.